I was born in Indonesia. I lived there for about 6-7 years before coming to Illinois, where I lived in Buffalo Grove for most of my life. My parents are both Korean, and Buffalo Grove is a nice neighborhood. It's small, it's quiet, it's predominantly white, not a lot of other minority groups.
Growing up Korean, like in a white community, it was okay at first.
I didn't think it was weird. That's what's normal to me. That's what has always been normal, and I didn't really think anything bad about it. I used to go to a small Catholic school with about 20 other kids in my grade, and it was a very, very white school. There are not a lot of other people of color there.
Like, it was kind of weird being Korean at school, being Asian, being a bit different from the other kids. Yeah, I was the only Korean kid in my grade.
I started to feel different around sixth grade,
because that's when I kind of thought more about my identity, who I am, and who I am in comparison to other people.
Because when you're young, you just kind of don't really pay attention to stuff like that, like race, gender, whatever. You just don't really give it much thought.
But in sixth grade, it really started to hit me, like, you know, like, that I was different. My household was definitely different.
Back then, my mom would always pack a lunch for me. It was a very traditional Korean lunch, which often consisted of rice, various side dishes, such as kimchi, other pickled vegetables. Sometimes it would be like meat, sometimes it would just be vegetables. My favorite thing that she packed would probably just be bulgogi. Bulgogi is Korean beef marinated for however long, and it tastes really good. And that was probably one of my favorite things that she would pack. She'd pack that with rice and sometimes kimchi or another vegetable. When my mom first packed those, I brought them to school, I ate them, I brought it back home, and it was no problem really. But when other kids start to notice that I was eating things that were weird to them that they normally don't eat, because, you know, the other kids would just bring more traditional American white dishes like peanut butter and jelly sandwich or ham and cheese. So they saw that I was eating a dish, you know, that had rice and that had weird looking meat and weird looking vegetables, and it was just, it looked gross to them. So to tease me for that, other people decided to make a joke out of it. It was weird for me. I felt different. I didn't want to feel different. I started to not like eating what my mom would cook. One day, you know, it was really embarrassing. Like, it really got to me that that every time in lunch, I would bring my lunchbox and people would point at it, make fun of it, say ew whenever they saw what was inside. It got to me. So one day I just told my mom that I didn't want her to pack all these lunches for me anymore. I just wanted something simple. Either just get me whatever the school has to offer, or just pack me like a sandwich and chips and soda like all the other kids were having. It was embarrassing. I felt like my parents were setting me up to get teased because they're the ones packing my lunches, right? I didn't really give thought to, they're just packing what they grew up eating and what they knew I liked. I started to reject a lot of my culture. I stopped speaking Korean. I stopped eating Korean food. I tried to hide the fact that I was even Korean, even though physically, you know, I am Korean. And this wasn't just at school. This was at home as well.
I regret it, but I honestly couldn't blame myself. I can't blame myself for feeling different and feeling like ashamed of who I am, because I was young and I was different.
I wish I could just go back in time and just eat every meal my mother packed for me.
I love my mom's cooking. To think now, like, you know, that my mom would wake up every day, pack up, cook something new, pack it just for me every day, and then for me to tell her that no, I don't want this anymore. I don't want you to bring this because I just want a normal American lunch. That must have hurt her feelings, and that makes me feel really sad because she's definitely like put a lot of heart into every, and I wish that I just didn't pay attention, didn't give any notice to what everyone else was saying. I just ate what I wanted to eat and didn't let it affect me or change my mindset.
It took a lot of maturing for me to realize that I shouldn't be ashamed for who I am. My parents are both amazing people who work really hard for me, and they're just trying to raise me the way that their parents raised them. One of my first days at Columbia, I had a bunch of friends over at my place, and I cooked for them like a very traditional Korean barbecue dish, and they loved it. All of us had a great time just eating the food that my mom would cook for us, eating the food that my dad would cook for us. Just, I didn't feel ashamed at all. I had my friends, I had my food. What more could I want? Asian people rock, yo!